You've probably done it hundreds of times. Downloaded a software patch and installed it on your smartphone or laptop. Patches fix vulnerabilities. And what are those? Are they the same thing as backdoors? Actually, no. A vulnerability is a weakness or flaw that can be exploited. Vulnerabilities in software are common, but they're mistakes, bugs, basically. When people talk about cybersecurity, they sometimes use the terms vulnerability and backdoor to mean the same thing. That's wrong. All software and hardware systems have vulnerabilities. The best you can hope to do is find them and fix them. Tech companies do this all the time. From 2018 to 2019, companies around the world found and reported almost 30,000 vulnerabilities. Now that may sound bad, but it's actually good news. If a vulnerability goes unreported, it won't get fixed. It might get exploited by a bad actor. So those patches you've been receiving, keep installing them. If a network is a house, a vulnerability is a badly installed window. A mistake can make it easier for a burglar to crawl inside. But it certainly wasn't done on purpose. Vulnerabilities and backdoors, not the same thing. A backdoor is a secret entrance, deliberately built for illegal access. Now, it's important to appreciate this distinction and how the US government has been misusing the word backdoor in relation to Huawei. Several US politicians have claimed China has backdoor access to networks that use Huawei equipment. That's nonsense. There's no evidence to support this claim. They either don't understand basic cybersecurity, or they're just trying to confuse people. Unfortunately, some of the people they confuse are journalists. Last year, for example, Bloomberg reported that Vodafone had found hidden vulnerabilities in Huawei equipment. But the story mistakenly called those vulnerabilities backdoors. Vodafone responded, saying the story was wrong. Back in 2011 and 2012, the company had identified a vulnerability that was part of a routine diagnostic function, not a backdoor. To its credit, Bloomberg corrected the story, but the damage was already done. The incorrect version was already out, got picked up, repeated by the media. That is how misinformation spreads. Here's another example. Robert O'Brien, President Trump's national security advisor, told the Wall Street Journal in February the US government had evidence that Huawei could access private data from networks around the world. And not quite. Turns out O'Brien was talking about something called lawful interception. This lets governments get access to network data under special circumstances. Most governments require telecom operators to install these access points. If police are trying to catch a criminal, lawful interception lets them do it. Not only are these interfaces required by law, they're standardized across the telecoms industry. Every company that makes network equipment has to include them. People who work in the telecoms industry know all this stuff. The US government either doesn't know, or it's deliberately using alarmist terms like backdoor to spread disinformation about Huawei. Also, Huawei has gone on record as saying we are ready to sign contracts with governments agreeing never to install backdoors. If we were to do so after signing such a contract, it would be corporate suicide. So, what's the key takeaway? A vulnerability is not a backdoor. Software comes with bugs. That's part of life. It's our job to find vulnerabilities and fix them. Backdoors are malicious and illegal. We all need to keep an eye out for them. But calling a vulnerability a backdoor is a case of either disinformation or ignorance, neither of which makes the networks you use any safer.